Welcome back. So the topic for today's video is how to generate and store files on Salesforce using Apex. So we will be looking at three objects which will be required to generate and store files on Salesforce using Apex. So the first object is content document. So this object is useful to store or upload document in Salesforce. So the definition or the meaning of content document is it is useful for storing or uploading documents to Salesforce library, and we don't store the files in Salesforce using this object. It is automatically created when we create a content version. So you can see it here, it was written, it automatically gets created when you create a content version, and content version is a child of content document. So we have looked at one object called as content document. Now the next object is content version, which is used to store the versions of the files which we are storing in Salesforce files. So what is content version? It represents a specific version of a document in Salesforce CRM content or Salesforce files, and content version is equivalent to a object which we have earlier seen, which is attachment. So this object has been existing in the Salesforce ecosystem, but now we are using content version. So you can store a version using content version or using attachment object, but in this video we will be looking at the object called content version. And the next object is content document link. So what is the use of this object? This object will share the files with users, records, groups, etc. So we can create multiple records to attach the same files between various records. So we have one file and we can share this file with n number of records, and this object stored files parent ID in the linked entity ID field. So these are the three objects. First object is content document, which is used to upload files in the Salesforce ecosystem or to store files in Salesforce. Content version is used to store the specific version of a document, and content document link is used to share the files with users, records, groups, etc. Now there are two fields, one is content document ID and another is version ID. So when we load a document into content version, Salesforce will create a record in content document. We have seen it earlier. However, if you upload a new version of the document, a new record will be created for content version but not for content document. So when we upload a file for first time, a content version is created and a content document is created. But now after some time we upload a new version, then the content document will not be created, but a new version of the file will be created. So that's the meaning of content version and content documents. Now let's have a look at official docs and learn about it more. So you can find the official documents in the Salesforce API guide, and this is content version and this is content document link, and we can see the definition which I have copied from here is written here. A file can be shared with other users, groups, records and Salesforce CRM content library. So we will be using these documents to create our Apex class to generate and store files in Salesforce ecosystem, and we will be sharing the file generated with one of the contact. So we will be sharing the file with the contact named as Andy Young, and the file will appear in the related list of contact object or contact called Mr. Andy Young. So let's begin with writing actual code. I have created a file Apex class named as generate and save PDF. So public static void and save PDF. I am naming the First of all, we don't have to create the object called as content document because it will be created automatically. We will create content version. So I am commenting something. We will be inserting content version here. So content version C version equals to new content version. Let's also create a string which will be storing, and we will be saving the file as PDF. So I am writing in this line number 7, I am creating some data which I will be writing in that PDF. So this is to be stored in PDF. This is the content which we will be storing in the file. Now let's look now the fields which are required to be set are, the first is content location, and the meaning of content location we will be seeing in some seconds. So I am the value of content location which I am setting is S. So let's look at the meaning of it, content location. And you can say content location means origin of the document, and there are three values which are valid, S, E and L. Document is located within Salesforce, so it is represented as S. If document is located outside of Salesforce, it is represented as E. And if document is located on social network, then it is represented as L. So we are storing the file in Salesforce itself, so we are using S. So this is for the location of the content. Now the next is the title, cversion dot title, that the name of the file. So test file. Now we have the title. Now we will be saying the path, or we can say it all path on client represent the file type which we will be saving, cversion dot title. So name, and I am appending dot pdf, which means I am storing the file as pdf. Now the next thing is we will be storing the data on the cversion. So version data, and which will be equals to blob dot, and we will converting the content into the pdf format. So the function or the method which I am using is to pdf, and I will pass the string in which I have written the data, and I will insert our C version. There are some errors, let me see why is showing errors. So yeah, let me tell you the meaning of path on client in the official document and the version data. So let's search for path on client, and path on client, one of the field that determines the file type. So it is used for determining the type of the file which we will be storing in Salesforce. And the next is title field, and which will be equals to, where it is, yeah, title will represent the title of the document. Here you can see the description. And the next field which we have set is version data, and if it represent the content or body of the file. So you can read about all the various fields which you can set in content version object from here. I will leave the link in the description field. So this is all about content version. Now let's create the link between the records with whom we will be sharing this file with. So for that we have to get the content document ID. So I will write a what we say as a query to get the ID of content document, because we know that whenever we create a content version, a content document is created itself, which will be created automatically. So I will be querying content for content document ID from content version, because these two objects are linked with one another. So I can, what is happening with my typing, where ID equals to the object name C was, what is happening, C were version dot ID, and after that I will be content document ID. I hope it will not give error. So we have fetched the ID of the document which is stored in the Salesforce while creating content version. Now we will be sharing this document with one record, and the record which with I will be sharing this file is the record named as Mr. Andy Young, which is of object type as contact, and this is the ID which I will be copying in some seconds. So content document link c doc link equals to new content document now after date c doc link dot the first thing which we'll be sharing is setting is content document id and it is equals to content document which we have gotten what is content document I hope it will not give error after this we will setting one more so this line will tell with which record we are sharing this file with so I am sharing the file which we are storing with this code with the object contact and the record named as Mr. Andy Young I will be copying the object id from here record id from here so let me copy it I will be sharing it with and let's paste it here now c doc link dot visibility let's set the visibility of the file which is I will be sharing it with all users let me write is correct and the next thing is c doc link dot share type and it is equals to view so let me tell you the meaning of these three thing so first is visibility so control f visibility let's go to the visibility field specify whether this file is available for all user internal user or shared users so with whom we are sharing the file with so there are three values one is all user second is internal user and third is shared user and I am writing all user so this file is available to all user who have permission to see the file so I am sharing it with all user and the second thing is share type so let's understand about it share type what happened okay I am searching in the wrong document share type so the permission granted to the user of the shared file so what is the permission we are giving the viewing permission here so it's done now let's insert c doc link and I will want to show you that currently there are no files shared with the object contact and the record Mr. Andy Young so with currently there are no files shared with it with him and after executing this code we will see a file named as test file and with extension pdf so test file.pdf will be generated and the data which will be present is this is to be stored in pdf so let's run it file let's debug open execute anonymous window after date let me write generate and save pdf dot save pdf semicolon and let me execute it highlighted I hope it will not give error so it's execute let me refresh this page and see if a file is created and it's also shared with this record so you can see a file called as test file of type pdf is created and let's see the content of this file by clicking on it and it's saying that no preview available why it's happening like this am I done something wrong this is to be stored in pdf it should work log.2pdf.test data let me open the window and see what wrong, what is thing, one thing which I am doing wrong here is let's save it as text file and see if a text file will be generated or not. And let's refresh it. So text file is generated, and again there are some problem with preview it. Let me download it and see if the content will be visible after downloading the file. So you can see that the content are visible after downloading it. Let's also download the PDF file and see if there its content is also visible or not. So it's also working, but there is something some problem with my developer org. So it will work if you try in a new org. So yeah, that's it. In this video we have learned about three object. The first one is content version, which is used to store the version of the file which we are creating, and the second object is content document, which is automatically created when we create a object called content version, and the third object is content document link, which is used to share a file with specific users, groups or record. And in this case we have shared the file with a record called as object contact and a record with a name Mr. NEM. Let's do one thing, let's share this record, this object, with one more record. Let's share it with this ABC and see if it work or not. So in my developer org, let me change the linked entity ID and replace it with the current copied ID. I hope I have copied it. Yes. Let's run it and it will work. Let's refresh. And you can see that a file is created and it's also shared with a new record called as ABC. So that's in this video. This is how we generate and store file in Salesforce using Apex. Thank you very much.